Yo, what is good YouTube? It is your boy Make America Lit, back with another NBA 2K22 video. And in today's episode of Badge Breakdown, we are going to be looking at catch and shoot, so let's just jump right into it. The description says, for a short time after receiving a pass, the receiver's ability to knock down threes gets a significant boost. Now, if you notice in the description, significant boost, yeah, whatever. But what you should be looking at is to knock down threes. They switched the way catch and shoot works. I believe with the patch update in season 2 or whatever, catch and shoot in previous 2Ks, and I believe even in the beginning of the year, applied to all shots. Close shots, mid-range shots, threes, deep threes. This batch would pop for any type of catch and shoot situation or scenario. With the update in season 2, they pretty much nerfed the badge, and now the badge only works for threes. It doesn't work for mid-range shots. It does not work for close shots anymore. It also does not work for deep shots. So if you think you're going to stack catch and shoot and limitless spot up, guess again, you're not stacking these two badges. Limitless spot up only works by itself. Just like chef only works by itself, catch and shoot works by itself. So catch and shoot, you will only get that badge if you catch the ball and shoot a three or a corner three. This is the only places where you can catch and shoot the badge or get the badge to pop. You can step back a little bit from the three-point line, but once you reach limitless spot up territory, you will no longer get the boost from catch and shoot. You will only get the boost from limitless spot up or from wherever you're standing or chef or whatever like that. So that right there is another reason why people feel like the shooting has been touched, or people aren't hitting as many shots and stuff like that, because they nerfed the badges, the way the badges activate and how you activate the badges and stuff like that. In my opinion, I've ran Hall of Fame catch and shoot. I've ran every level of catch and shoot. I have a glass cleaner, so I play around with it. I have a play shot that I play around with it as well. Hall of Fame is very nice, but I personally feel like if you know your jump shot and you can green a shot, you don't really need Hall of Fame catch and shoot. It's nice to have that, you know, safety net just in case you mistime your shot or whatever like that and you want to get that extra boost or whatever. But me personally, I think the sweet spot is really silver. If you're a primary ball handler, you are a play shot or a playmaker or whatever like that, and you're going to be having a ball in your hand more often than not, then you really don't need a catch and shoot at a high level. You can get away with a bronze catch and shoot, in my opinion. I only run bronze catch and shoot on my play shot, but on my glass cleaner, I normally spot up. On that build, I'm running it anywhere between silver and gold. I don't think I need Hall of Fame on it, although I can get Hall of Fame. I just think that there's way other badges that I can use that will activate in more scenarios than just a catch and shoot three. You know what I mean? Like, there's way better badges that I would rather upgrade, because, you know, catch and shoot no longer works for mid-range shots, close shots or whatever like that, or limitless shots or whatever. So I just feel like the catch and shoot badge, already it wasn't that good. You know, it was always a solid, like a B or A tier badge, just a solid badge, you know what I mean? Not like a bad badge, but since they nerfed it and the ways that you can use it in the situations that it will be used, I just don't think it's as good as it was before. It's been your boy, Make America Lit. I'm out, man. Peace.